We're just about ready to kick off today's qualifying here in Melbourne. It's the Australian Grand Prix. This is the kind of track that eats rear tyres for breakfast, or so I'm told by more experienced drivers than myself.
Lots of low-speed exits means the rears are in for a lot of punishment. It's all too easy to spin them up coming out of a corner too aggressively. It might look great for us as spectators, as we love to see a car driven beyond its limits, but it's not going to result in a great long-run pace.
Right. Let's have a Lando Norris at McLaren. Oh, how's about that? Lucas Weber with George Russell as his teammate and Devin at Toro Rosso. Well, looks like I'm in for a stroll in the park. Yes, yes, yes. Of course, the car was at Reynolds. I've been that used to him being at Red Bull.
Thank you. Devin Butler ahead of me in qualifying?
Yeah, I don't think so.
Someone's about to go down. I'm going to send him back to where he came from. Yeah, I could get away with a one stop. I'm smart with my tyre management. Let's go. Take some of those corners a little bit faster, should be okay. And of course the tyres I set my fastest lap on are the tyres I'm going to be starting at least with. Well, it's an improvement. I should get an extra tenth out of that.
Oh, snap, I just made the top 10. I just made the top 10. Woo-wee.
Just as well I made an imp- just as well I went out for that extra lap. It does mean that I'm gonna be on slightly worn tyres. Oh my word, that was worth it. Those are the tires I'll be starting with, so. Right. There's only going to be 10 cars out there anyway. First time in my career, I believe I've made it into the top 10 qualifying. Bad. I'm confident I can go a little bit faster than that.
Nice! Right. Get a fresh set on. Let's go for one more lap. One more try. Not even close. Not even close.
We're all ready for tomorrow's race, but before we begin, let's have a quick look at those who will be fronting the grid. Vettel, Hamilton, and Valtteri Bottas. With qualifying complete, all that remains
sixth
is the
place.
Main event. We'll be
Not
live
bad.
And uninterrupted for the Grand Prix tomorrow, so make sure you join us then. New drivers, new cars, it's a new Formula One season. But it's the same Albert Park that we've come to know and love for more than two decades now, that plays host to round one of a 21-race championship that takes us from here in Australia, across the globe, and the eventual season finale at the Yas Island Circuit in Abu Dhabi. We have plenty of changes to the sport this year, with tweaks to the regulations, a fresh-looking spread of tyre compounds, and of course, some changes to the roster of car manufacturers. It's goodbye to Sauber, and hello once again to the classic name of Alfa Romeo in Formula One. It's also goodbye to Force India. They've been rebranded as Racing Point. Joining me to take you through all the action of the 2019 Formula One season is Anthony Davidson. And it's great to have you with us.
Thanks, Crofty. Always happy to be here, and I'm looking forward to getting underway. Last year was Mercedes' fifth constructors' title in a row, although for the first half of the season it was absolutely neck and neck with the Ferraris. Hopefully this year we can see the chasing pack take that final step, as I'd love to see a championship contest all the way up to the final race in Abu Dhabi. Another story to keep an eye on is the performance of Red Bull, who have switched to the Honda power unit this year. What that will mean for both their performance and reliability remains to be seen.
It's time to see how our drivers are stacking up after yesterday's exciting qualifying session. Sebastian Vettel will start on pole. Fantastic qualifying from the multiple world champion. And it's Lewis Hamilton alongside. Considering the rest of the grid, we have Bottas, Gasly, Charles Leclerc, the Rainmaster, Verstappen, Perez, Hülkenberg, and Kevin Magnussen. Sainz, Grosjean, Devon Butler, and Ricciardo, Weber, Albon, Lando Norris, and Lance Stroll, Raikkonen, and George Russell ends our grid lineup. And now it's time to head down to the track.
That's pretty huge, Devon Butler out-qualifying George Russell. You'd expect Williams to be on similar pace. Ooh. That's not ideal. I'm not doing a three stop. No. That simply will not do. A two-stop, that'll do much more nicely. As you can see, the limit's now up to 110 kilos. That'll do. Session timer, excellent.
Are you all right there? Don't worry about the mistake, just focus on the rest of the race. Any changes to the weather today? Dry throughout. Don't let them get away from you. One of them might make a mistake that lets us back in.
Maybe that's where I've been. We'll be right back.
is clear. Weather is looking good for now. Rest of the grid is forming up. Be patient and watch for the lights.
Lights out and away we go for F1 2019! I'm trying to get my track control. We got a fast stop, but not as bad as far as I was expecting! Somehow I maintain position.
Take it easy on the car. We can't sustain this level of damage.
Newsflash!
Okay, clear.
Well, that's one out of the race already. Retro hasn't changed. One less driver spot.
Kimmy is in for his stop.
Ooh, that was nasty. Oh, that's his front wing gone.
What the hell are he doing?
That's his front wing gone. Let's have a look at the finished product. Oh, of course. Oh! Yep, he's not going any further. Excellent! I now have Devin Butler. Or should I say Mr. Smugface? Time to ensure this. Oh, you'll crash! You lose! You will never win! Thank you! We'll be right back.
narrow. And my streak of not scoring in Australia continues.
Red Bull pulling out all the stops today. What a great win. What do you think it was, Ant, that gave them the edge over the competition today?
Well, Crofty, this was won through an abundance of speed and an abundance of skillful overtakes. Inside, outside, cutting underneath, we saw it all today. And it's really nice to see a Grand Prix won in that manner. A race, surely, that will satisfy the purists today, I think.
Here come today's winners. The team at Red Bull have done a phenomenal job recently. It's clear to see that they've put in the work and they should be proud of the victory they secured here. So let's review the updated driver standings. Today's performance means Max Verstappen now owns the top spot in the Drivers' Championship. After an incredible day of racing, who was your driver of the day, Ant?
Well, Crofty, Daniel Ricciardo would have to be my driver of the day. It's less about what he did right, but how little he did wrong. Perfect driving.
It's time to see how things are shaping up in the Constructors' Championship. Ferrari take the lead at the top of the table. I'm equal parts exhausted and elated with this weekend of Formula One. Be sure to join us for the next one.
Mr. Smug has points and I don't.
Amazing performance out there. I'm sure you're pretty happy with that. That was a good race for Lucas. Are you pleased to see him doing well? You've had experience with Devon's fast, aggressive style. Any advice for the drivers he passed today? You really looked in control of your car out there. Your team must be thrilled. You had a bit of contact today. Who was at fault there? Great. Well, that's everything.
Thanks, Clip. I'm going to wipe that smug grin off to Mr. Smug Face. But I'll have to wait till Bahrain for that to happen.
Excellent result today. Finishes like that will look good on your contract reviews. On to the next one.
Looks like one of your rivals is also going to an upcoming historical event. If you choose to take him on, it might help get your name out there a bit. You're not the only driver to be hounded by the press. Emails, like the one I've just sent you, will give you an insight on how your former Formula 2 rivals are handling the press. Be sure to check your emails regularly, as I'll be sure to send you any of the more, let's say, interesting press transcripts that come my way.
Now putting more emphasis on the rivalries. more emphasis on the rivalries, where you've got your rivals attending these invitational events as well. And I got another achievement, by the way, folks. Early beginnings. So,
invitational event where some of the world's finest drivers will be treating us to a special exhibition of some of the sport's most iconic
cars. And I'm already a quarter of the way there. I mean, the game's only been out. Well, the game officially comes out tomorrow. But because I got the Legends Edition, I got it on Tuesday. I mean, look at this. I've already got 12 of the 25... I've already got 12 of the 50 achievements. Ah, the V8! How glorious! I have it on regular corner cutting, right? As you see, I am wearing my multiplayer uniform. Helmet and my summer suit. There we go. Passed with ease. Well, that reputation's gone up. But I don't give a damn, blah, damn it. I don't give a damn about my reputation.
Practice sessions are vital for the continuing development of the car. But if you need to, you can choose to simulate the session instead. It won't be as effective as having you behind the wheel directly, but it's better than missing the session entirely.
Didn't even think of that. And of course, why am I not surprised? Right. Are we done? And that does it here, folks. Hope you enjoyed what you saw. If you did, as always, hit the thumbs up. And if you want to be baptized into following this channel, hit the subscribe button down at the bottom, click the bell to join the live daily notification squad so you don't miss anything I do on this channel. My previous video is on the left, my F1 2019 playlist is on the right. And I'll see you guys again very soon. Until then, enjoy the rest of your day. Peace out, and as always, stay faithful.